him at WrestleMania 23.
I didn't think he would do it. I just was suggesting it, but that on top.
In the world of modern freakout culture, would you say this is the pinnacle? Maybe the highest it can get? Second most retweeted Trump tweet ever? Maybe it's the all of Twitter, I'm not sure. Second to Selena Gomez or something. Anyway, so I had a big list. I had a list of five reasons CNN needs to stop what they're doing, but I'm throwing that all away because of what happened over the last couple days. This huge, who knew that a WWE tweet would set everybody off, right? Hate speech and all that good stuff, inciting violence. But that's not the main focus I want to talk about. Let's look at some of the tweets that CNN's been doing here. Okay, so they found the guy who was doing the who made the meme of CNN getting wrestled by President Trump. They found the guy, emailed him, asked him to take it down. He said okay, and then afterwards here's what they said. Okay, CNN is not publishing Han Asshole Solo. That's his screen name, Han Asshole Solo. CNN is not publishing Han Asshole Solo's name because he's a private citizen who has issued an extensive statement of apology, showed his remorse by saying he has taken down all his offending posts, and because he said he is not going to repeat this ugly behavior on social media again. In addition, he said his statement could serve as an example to others to not do the same. CNN reserves the right to publish his identity should any of that change. So, Big Brother CNN, If you step out of line, we're going to publish all your shit online. And how are they combating this with people defending the guy's right to be a private citizen? They're saying, oh, he makes racist posts, racist memes. Like, okay, nobody's going to defend that. Nobody's going to say, like, you should make anti-Semitic or hateful memes. But it's just memes, people. They don't hurt anybody, okay? They're just funny pictures. And that doesn't mean you get to expose a guy. What did they say? Should any of that change, he's not going to repeat this. Oh, it sounds like a parent punishing their child. You clean your room and then you can go out, but if your room's dirty, well, then you can consider yourself grounded again. And there's more to it too. Let's last night it was trending, as you can see, hashtag CNN blackmail. So I had this already, I had my list already to go, but then they changed it on me, so I had to focus on this. We can talk about some of that still, but here's something else that I found. Buzzfeed declaring war on 4chan, basically. So I think this is from a private, it says Buzzfeed France tips group, and the woman's Cecilia something, Cecile. The vile racists of 4chan and Reddit are becoming worse by the second. As respected journalists who have the ear of millions, we are taking a stand against the violence promoted by Trump and his ilk. Okay. It's our mission, no, our duty, to make sure racism and Islamophobia are squashed and non-existent. So it's BuzzFeed's duty, everybody.
It's my duty to please that booty.
However, with Trump as president, this hate has been blown out of proportion, which he has been promoting against journalists. Reputable journalists, such as my good friends Andrew Kaczynski and Donnie O'Sullivan, are receiving death threats from vile racist and juvenile Islamophobes from Reddit and 4chan for exposing one of their ilk, who themselves are responsible for numerous unmaskings of peaceful protesters resisting that vile human being Trump. Okay, so first thing, you're talking about children, most likely. So you want to expose all these children, all these teenagers, young adults at home, trying to, you know, do something. I'm not saying it's the best thing they should be doing, but they're doing something, I guess. Expose all those hateful kids who are fucking trolling you. And the second thing is, they've unmasked peaceful protesters that resist blah, 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 Trump. They've unmasked Antifa people. You know, those domestic terrorists. They're just listed as a terrorist group in New Jersey because they destroy things and hit people with bike locks and pepper spray people instead of speaking to them. Those people. Okay, now we got that out of the way. And then they seem to call on for, this is where they call on for the doxing of them, which is revealing their personal information. I'm looking for any technologists. What is this, 1932? Phone me a technologist.
You hire these mugs, they miss. Now you're through. If you ain't out of town by tomorrow morning, you won't never leave it except in a pine box.
Who'd like to join the fight of exposing every one of these juvenile, racist, bigoted Islamophobes infesting these hateful communities? Everybody's an Islamophobe. You can criticize Catholicism for pedophilia and everything, but not Islam, right? We're looking for tech expert who could expose where and which companies pro-Trump communities use to communicate their hateful, bigoted, and Islamophobic messages. We tracked down the 4chan server location to San Francisco, and we are aware the content is served through blah, 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 blah. We're looking for precise locations, show their IP addresses. So basically, out everybody that you disagree with. It's pretty ridiculous. And CNN's gone too far this time, saying that any of that could change. Let's bring that back up. CNN reserves the right to publish his identity should any of this change. So we're going to ruin your life if you decide to go against us. Note that they don't care what happens to somebody else. They keep saying all the media is under attack, okay? No, it's just you, and to an extent, MSNBC, New York Times, Washington Post. But they've learned a little bit. You can tell that they've learned a little bit, but CNN hasn't for some reason. They keep doubling down. And they keep getting caught lying, too. I mean, the Russia thing for ratings, American Pravda from the Veritas guy with Van Jones saying it's a nothing burger, producer of their morning show saying that Chris Cuomo sucks, and most of the staff hates Trump, and they talk bad about Chris Cuomo. And they just don't get internet culture. They think this means anything. It's just a meme, people. If I was to tell you, like, 2 years ago that a meme would become international news and people would say that it's inciting violence, you'd probably think I'm crazy. But you'd also think that I'm a genius, I guess. Another thing that I don't like about CNN is usually when people get something so wrong, like political pundits get it really wrong, like they did with the whole election in the US, they fire people. But they have the same people committing the same mistakes all the time. They've got Chris Cuomo. He's the one that apparently his staff hates. He's the one that said you can't look at WikiLeaks, you can only get it through them. Don Lemon, he's constantly refuting things when he doesn't know what he's talking about. For example, if you've seen the interview with Amy Horowitz, where he's just like, no, these aren't the stats, these are the stats, the American government stats are better than the actual Swedish stats. And then Amy Horowitz was just like, here they are, and he's like, I don't need to look at those. Brian Stelter, have you seen his Twitter? Constantly crying about being mistreated, constantly crying about Trump attacking the media. But they're not attacking the media. That's what they don't seem to get. They're attacking CNN because it sucks. You ever watched it? It's always the same thing. It's always nonsense. And I'm glad that people finally are seeing through it. What about healthcare? What about jobs? What about the stock market? Instead, we get more Morning Joe, more Russia, more Trump hates the media, he's inciting violence. What about Europe? What about that Cates law that just passed? What about the extreme rape cases in Sweden just had to shut down a festival because there's too many rapes. People can't go to a music festival without getting raped. And one of them was what? She was 12 years old. So that's not news, I guess. But we're now on day five, depending on when you're watching this, of Trump WWE. What needs to happen is they just need to unleash WWE fans on these people. They'll defeat them. CNN reserves the right to publish his identity should any of that change. What a horrible precedent that is sent if everybody doesn't get together and say that's not okay. A horrible precedent. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to consider donating to me on Patreon every month. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.
Intellectual, you know, like fake news. It's fake. Like when Donald Trump says that you are fake news, like...
The conservative press fake news is their latest thing.
And Dan Rather, the godfather of modern media fake news.
I'm not going to give you a question.
Can you stay categorical?
You are fake news.
Sir,
go ahead.
Can you stay...